Wrecking Ball Radio.
This is Davin's Den.
Back, you're listening to Davin's Den. Thank you for hanging out with us. Going to do a little scamming scammers. So last week, my fake Davin's scammer, Han, what, you want $500?
Was it $500?
Yeah, I think it was $500 because wasn't she stuck?
Yeah. Oh, that's right. Yeah, she's stuck in an airport.
No, not an airport. No, and just in Germany, but you know.
Yeah, but I thought I got the.
I thought she was in an airport.
She was in an airport.
I don't know if she said that.
Oh, okay.
But she needs a favor.
Yeah.
So, I'm sure I will help her out.
Mm-hmm.
What a guy.
I am a guy. I am a guy.
I
will clarify
not
that.
Not what a guy.
I am a guy. All right. So, let's see how it works out for my dear. So, this is October 17th. I say, good afternoon. She goes, hi, dear. Good evening from here. I'm about to log in my Gmail so I can call you on Hangout soon. Few minutes. Remember, she wants a call.
Yeah.
And she gives me an emoji with a kiss. One of my favorite type of emojis that I can get is an emoji with a kiss. Because if she gave me an eggplant, I'd think she was a dude.
Yeah.
And that would bother me. Anyway, so I go, good evening. Don't rush it. It's only 4 p.m. your time, LOL. She goes, LOL. What are you doing at this moment? I go, I'm covered in oil, having my way with myself, thinking about you.
Oh, God.
What? I think it's best to be honest.
Yes, that is the best policy.
Covered in oil. You don't play.
I am.
Really?
She goes, smile with oil and emoji with tears coming. I go, oops, phone slipped out of my... And then I put a hand emoji. She goes, LOL. I go, so much baby oil. So much.
So much time.
She goes, what's that for? I go, no friction. And it's sexy as hell.
Gets baby oil by the quart.
Pennzoil.
Pudzoil.
Pudzoil, there you go. I go, how is my dragon emoji today? She goes, hello, how is your day going? I go, how could you laugh at such sexiness? I go, I'm not laughing, dear, but I'm passing through much streets here, and I want to come back home. Try to understand me. Almost got embarrassed since yesterday. I go, you said, lol, why? She goes, I was thinking about your words, but had to act like I don't because of what's happening to me here. Remember, I think I was like being all flirty.
Oh, yeah.
I go, why do you feel the need to act? She goes, I need to leave here and come back home before I can feel much happy, and you should understand. My daughter would be bothered, too. Well, let's leave your daughter out of this. Mm-hmm. I don't need your daughter to feel much happy.
You don't want you don't want her daughter in your head while you're covered in oil.
Yeah.
Well, how old's the daughter? The daughter's old, too young.
I think she's young.
Yeah, she needs a babysitter, so that's creepy.
Yeah, that's creepy.
That's not
good.
No, it's not like I'm a teacher or anything.
Back up.
I go, I understand. She goes, did you get my message on Hangout? I go, no. She goes, I just messaged you. I go, just got it. So then she tries to call me. So let me go over to Hangouts real quick. So she tries to call me.
Is it a video call?
I don't know.
Oh.
I don't remember what it is, to be honest with you.
Wow.
But nonetheless, it's a correspondence.
He's got so many chicks, he can't even remember what happens between them.
He's a ladies' man.
Yeah, I see.
Or
that.
A lady might be a man.
Okay. Yes, that's true, too. He doesn't know what he's dealing with.
Hold on here. All right. So here is our first...
You hold on, Mr. Pudzoil.
First call. Pudzoil, funny.
No, that's Joe.
I understand. I know where it came from. I know its origin story.
How you doing?
Good. How are you?
I'm fine. I kind of call you, but, you know, I wanted to use someone's laptop over here, and that's the only help she had to offer me, but I don't know, and now she's gone. So I was trying to call you, but you were not picking up the calls. I don't know why.
I wasn't by my computer. I was working out.
Okay.
Why are you out of breath?
What did you say?
I said, why are you out of breath?
I am not, but, you know, I told you, I have to leave here. I'm just having little issues right now, and I'm not really happy.
No, I get that. So why aren't we doing a video call?
I don't know when she's going to come back, because that was the only help she told me she can offer, and And now I wanted to use the laptop to call you, and you were not picking up, and presently she's gone. I don't know.
Oh, I see. That's unfortunate.
So what are you doing? What are you doing presently?
I was just about to run out, do some errands, hop in the shower and do some errands.
Okay. So, when are we going to talk? I don't know. I told you, I don't know if you can help me because I really have to come back home before I can get things fixed up. And,
yeah, it doesn't...
You know, I explained everything to you, and please, can we talk on chat because I don't know the... can we talk on chat, please?
I thought you wanted to talk to me here.
I know, but someone is here right now. You know, I told you the agent is with me, and it's causing a lot of trouble to me. I don't know. And
do you want me to talk? You want me to talk to the agent? I can talk to the agent for you.
Okay. So let me call you back a few minutes. Okay.
You're gonna call me here?
Yeah, I'm gonna call you.
But if the agent's with you, why do you gotta hang up?
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay. You talk to him and I'll wait.
Okay. Hello?
Hello? Yes.
How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. So what's going on?
Okay. Yeah, everything is going on fine.
Okay.
What about you?
Everything's really good over here. So what can I help you with? What's going on? What are you doing to my friend Hanh over there?
Okay, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, I can hear you very well now.
Okay.
The network was very bad. That was why I couldn't hear you initially.
Okay, I was expecting more of a German accent from you.
Okay, that's not a problem.
Oh, you're gonna give
can
me a German?
Hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. I can hear you. So you're in Frankfurt with Hanh? You're in Frankfurt?
Yeah, I'm a friend to her.
Oh, you're a friend of hers.
I hope he told you what happened. Everything that happened.
Okay, because she told me you were She told me you were an agent.
Yeah, I'm an agent.
But you're an agent and a friend. You're an agent and a friend, kind of like a double agent. Yeah? Hello? Huh. That's unfortunate.
All right, so what do we think of that, kids?
Oh, man, they don't know how to do this at all.
Look at Pip criticizing. Just two kids trying to make some money. And Pip's like, I don't like your game.
Yeah, no.
Why was there crickets and stuff in the background? It's not like they were calling outside.
Noises.
I guess that's a very rural airport they're in Germany.
Well, I did call him on the accent thing.
Yeah, that was great.
That was great. And he's like, yeah, I am a friend of hers. It's like, that's not what I said. Are you in Frankfurt? He goes, yeah, I'm in Frankfurt. So he didn't say Frankfurt. He said something else. Frankfurt.
He was so not expecting to be called on that. He was so unprepared.
They're like, It's like, you gotta get on the phone. Yeah. It's like, what am I gonna say? Just, you can think of something.
That girl did sound Asian, though, right?
She sure did, yeah.
And I'm dealing with an Asian woman.
Sounds like an Asian woman.
Yeah.
But who?
He sounds a little African-y.
Yes, he does.
He does not sound Germany.
No.
So did you like the way I heard that I handled that?
Yeah. And so he goes, oh, that's not a problem. Oh, so now you're going to put on an accent.
Oh, good. See, nice. It's all good. All right.
Yeah. It's like, oh, yeah, I'm a friend of hers. I thought you were an agent.
So, oh, yeah, but a friend and an agent. Oh, so you're a double agent.
And then he's like, oh, I don't even know what that means.
Hummada.
Now, think about this. This guy didn't know whether to shit or wind his watch.
Could have done both.
Do you think he is going to go on with the ruse as an agent?
No.
He doesn't know.
He has no clue how to play this.
Hey, look, we're entertainers. We do bits. We do this. So if you go, I'm like, well, I was General Bulldog McIvey. It's like, what do you think Joe's going to know how to be? You're damn right. I don't be a fucking giant. Yeah. I don't be a giant. But, you know, because I'm an entertainer. I do bits. But this guy doesn't know he's going to
be. He doesn't know we're doing a bit.
Yeah, right.
Right. I know we're doing a bit. That's you right. Don't know we're doing it. Yeah. They're doing a bit, but they have a different show.
Oh, and apparently he doesn't have the script.
No, he does not have the script.
No.
There's been a rewrite.
Does not.
I've rewritten
it. It would have been nice if he got some sides into him.
And the time to call a writer's meeting.
Really?
But he got the damn receiver.
So you like the way that was handled?
Oh my God, that was great.
So we have an Asian woman, it would appear.
Yes.
And an African man.
Yes.
Would you like to hear more?
Yes.
Okay. I'll cue that up for my friends.
Now this is the same call?
No. Second call. Hello?
Hello?
Hey.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay, you were talking to the agent.
No, he said it was your friend.
No.
Yes.
No, he's not.
He said he's your
friend. He's
the agent. Yeah, no, he said he's your friend.
No, that was not what to say to you. Maybe you can talk to him one more time, okay?
Can you hear me very well?
I can hear you. I can hear you well, yes.
Yeah, what I was trying to say is that I gave her some money.
You gave her some money.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Yeah, you can hear me very well now.
Yeah, well, okay, so you're, all right, so you know what? I should probably get some information on you so I can better help. Give me 1 second. I'm going to get a pen and paper. Hold on 1 second.
Yeah, can you hear me very well?
I can hear you perfectly clear. Okay.
Okay.
So what is your name? What is your name, sir?
Can you hear me?
I can hear you. What is your name, sir?
Yeah, my name is James.
James, and your last name?
Is that? Mm-hmm.
Yes, your last name. I need to get some documentation so I can help my buddy Han. Yeah, I need some documentation so I can help Han out. So, what?
Why you have to do that initially? Because I have this benevolent mind to help people. That's what I've always trying to do, always, to help people.
Okay.
So I tried helping her, you know, she's about leaving. Mm-hmm. She has to give me the money for leave.
You're holding her prisoner?
Yeah.
That doesn't sound very nice.
Yeah, you know, what I'm trying to say is that, you know, I helped her initially, so she has to be very kind to me in returning the money back.
I understand.
If she does not return the money back, because if she does not return the money back, I didn't see her as a good person. Yeah, I didn't see her as a good person because I tried all my best to help her.
Right.
When she had none.
Right.
And now we're talking about being realistic over here.
Realistic.
I'm being realistic, and I don't like doing things that don't favor me. Now I did it for her. She has to do that same favor for me too by returning the money I had to give to her.
Right. Right. So so you're an agent, and I guess you're handling this for Han. What company are you with, James? Your company, sir.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you. It seems like you can't hear me when I have questions. What company are you with? Huh. Got silent again. Hate when that happens. You there? Hello?
Can you hear me?
Dude, I can hear you loud and clear.
Yeah, the network is bad.
Yeah.
I can hear you.
All right.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yes, I'm going to speak very slowly so it doesn't echo too much. James. James.
Okay, no problem.
What?
Okay.
Yes. What company are you an agent with?
A-Piece.
Excuse me? AP?
A-Piece. Do you know about A-Piece?
No. Can you spell that for me, sir?
Oh, A-I-R-P-E-A-C-E.
P-E-A-C. Oh, Air Peace. Okay.
Yeah.
And this is a travel agency?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So, and your website is airpeace.com, correct?
No, not.
What's your website?
Oh, okay. Can you hear me?
I can hear you, man.
Can you hear me now?
I can hear you now.
Now, can you hear me very well?
I can hear you amazingly well.
I don't have, because now, let me tell you the truth and nothing but the truth. Because now I didn't just want to stay here and listen to anything again, because everything I told her, I thought she was going to give me the money when she called me since yesterday. I don't know about what you're trying to say now, because I really want my money, because if I don't get my money, I'm going to hold her hostage.
How are you going to hold her hostage? Do you know she's like a ninja? Yeah, She's a ninja. She will rip out your heart and make you eat it. You're not going to hold her hostage, man. I know this girl. She's an ass kicker. So forget about holding the hostage thing. Don't even make threats to me, because you're fucking with the wrong motherfucker, James. James, I will get a yak unit over there so fucking quick that your head will spin around. So don't make threats, James. We can handle this like gentlemen, but don't you make a threat, James. I just can't sit for that. And I don't think air peace.
If you want us to handle it like gentlemen, yes, you just have to do it in a peaceful way.
That's what, but the, but I can hear you. But James, air peace would not want you.
My money.
James.
You understand me?
James.
Now, wait, you want to do it like a gentleman. So I want to do it like a gentleman to you now.
Well, James, when you threaten my friend over there, we're no longer gentlemen.
I can see you don't want to see reasons to, with me now. Now you want to turn me to a bad person that I helped her initially, and you can help her now when she's in need. I don't know what you say now. Now I have to give the phone to her so we can talk to her.
Yes.
I don't know, because now what I want now is my money, because I helped her. I helped her sincerely. When I helped her, I never gave excuses. Are you hearing me?
I'm hearing you.
I want to help her. I want to give her excuses. So you don't have to give me excuses.
All right, James. James, we are tracking this phone call. I will have people there very soon, James. So do not get loud or it will not end well for you. You clearly do not know who you're talking to. So you will talk to me like a gentleman, and you will talk to my friend Han like a gentleman, or this will not end well.
Okay, now I'm talking like a gentleman. Okay. What do you want us to do?
What do I want? I need to go to your website and talk to your CEO and understand what's going on. Because I don't understand how you're personally lending her money and then you're threatening to hold her hostage.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
I helped her. I never helped her from my own force. I helped her out of my own kindness. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
I just gave her the money because I know, yes, I'm benevolent in nature. I have to give it to her so she could sort one or two things that she told me about.
James, what city are you in, James?
See, I'm not here for these questions. If you want to give me money, you talk to
no,
me.
No, no. You know what? I tell you what, James. I don't want to give you the money because you better not hold her hostage, because I got people on the way and they will fucking kill you. So don't fuck around, James. I don't like that. I try to handle this like gentlemen to help my friend, but you're coming across really bad throwing the word hostage out. Do you know what Americans do in hostage situations? We don't negotiate with people who take hostages, James. We fucking put a bullet in their head. I don't want to have to do that. Do you know who I work with? No, you don't, because I'm just another guy on the internet. But I'm a bad motherfucker, James. So don't talk about hostages to my dear good friend Han. I don't like that type of language.
Hello?
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Agent is gone right now. I don't know. He don't want to listen to anything. I don't know.
Yeah, he's probably running away.
It's not running away. I told you. He just helped me. I don't know.
No, you didn't tell me that. No, you didn't tell me that, Han. This is a new little twist on the story here. But he's telling me he's going to hold you hostage. Now, we've established you're a ninja and an ass kicker, so how can this little punk hold you hostage?
I don't know. Maybe it's peace. I don't know why. And I don't just have much to say right now. I'm so disappointed and I'm tired. I don't know. I don't just know what to say.
Well, you know, I'm going to do some research on this company Airpeace, all right? Because I'm going
to... What it told you was that he doesn't have any website, or as in he doesn't have anything concerning the website. He just helped me out of his
No. He said he's the travel agent, Han. You said he's the travel agent. Come on, girl. Let's get the story right. Let's go. Let's go. Let's do a little better. Let's do better.
Oh my God. I don't want to talk much. I don't know. It seems you're yelling at me.
I'm trying to help you, Han. I'm trying to help you, but.
Kids?
Is it worth the money? Is it really, on their end, is it really worth the money?
Oh my God.
All right, kids, give me some thoughts.
Well, one of the things that I thought was really amusing is because I'm sitting here with the Airpiece website.
Is it really? Is there really?
Yeah, I believe it's a private, like, jet Nigerian company.
Well, it's one of the, it's like, it's scrolling different things that they offer. And it goes to Dubai, but it also happens to, wait for it, fly to Accra.
Oh! And remember, they're in Germany.
I know, sure they are. It goes to Lagos and...
Lagos is Nigeria, Accra's Ghana.
Yeah, Accra's Ghana. It's, yeah, this is going back and forth to the Middle East and Africa.
Nothing about Germany. I believe it's like a private jet, though.
Well, yeah.
It's not like commercial airlines.
It doesn't... It's,
and she's from America, allegedly.
She's from America, and she's... There doesn't seem to be any flights to Frankfurt. Let me just put in...
How about New York or Albany? Anything there?
No.
That's where she says she lives.
Okay.
Stupid. There's an airport there.
Nigerian, Nara, Ghana, U.S. This is a drop-down menu. U.S. dollar, Gambia, Sierra Leone, Senegalese.
Those are countries.
UAE and Liberian. Oh, this is the different ways you can pay.
So, how do you think that went?
On your side, excellent. On their side,
that was a very aggressive fake, Davin.
Yeah, yeah. I saw you really turned. It's interesting the way it turned. You turned it nasty.
And you should know how that works.
Yeah, but the thing is, sometimes with the scammers will be, oh, you know, my friend, calm down. He got just as angry.
Oh yeah.
You notice how there was something, you know, that wanted
to get the money. I kept on focusing on a hostage.
Well,
hostage.
And also asking him questions he was not prepared to answer.
No.
So he came up with Airpeace because it's something that he's familiar with. They only fly to Dubai and Africa.
Well, this doesn't seem legitimate at all.
Somehow, Frankfurt seems off the chart. No, he had no idea what to say. And then the whole cockamamie, well, I was helping her out of the goodness of my heart, but now I'm going to hold her hostage.
You like how we put bullets in it?
Yeah.
You don't fuck around with Americans and say the word hostage. We don't negotiate. We put bullets in heads. Is that what you want? That was great.
I think they were flustered.
Oh, God. They were not expecting that.
Do you think they were scared?
Do I think they were scared? I don't know. I don't think they were scared. But I think they were taken aback.
Because,
I think they had to regroup.
Because this guy might be a nut.
Oh, I think we've established that.
Yeah.
And this guy might come after us.
He's like, I have people on the way. We've tracked this phone call. You don't know who I work for. And they're like, shit, we don't really know who we work for.
We just met on Instagram. It all seemed like so much fun. He was just covered in oil a second ago, I swear.
We were just playing. Then all of a sudden, shit got real.
I had this guy that was trying to scam money out of me. He wrote in. He goes, oh, we have photos on you, video of you on porn sites and stuff like that. If you pay us $5,000, we won't post them. And I wrote to them, I go, first of all, I'm a gay porn star. And I go, and because there is a Joe Curry that's a gay porn star.
Get out.
I swear to God. And I go, go find my videos. And I go, there's about 50 different videos of me doing that. I go, number two, I am also under the teachings of Sakawa. And I go, you picked the wrong person. I go, one of your relatives, I will put a spell, and you will lose a relative a week, and I'm not even going to tell you. You'll find out as they go. So I go, you better be hearing the last, this will be the last you're hearing of me, or you will pay the consequence. So I knew all the things to tell, you know.
See, we educate.
Yeah. Never hurt, because he wasn't expecting that.
No,
he
no, wasn't
expecting. And you weren't recording? What's wrong with you?
Yeah.
Nobody expects. No, that is just amazing. It's great seeing them getting like flustered.
Well, because remember, they work on the element of surprise.
Yes.
I am working on the element of surprise. I know it's not going to go well for them.
No.
I don't know how it's not going to go well, but I know they're not getting money. This much I know. And for him to use the word hostage, well, he triggered me.
Yeah, well, apparently. But the other thing is that he thought that this was going to be like, oh no, well, I'll cough up the dough. It's like, yeah, not fake Davin.
Fake Davin ain't coughing up shit, motherfucker.
No, and I'll speak to the gate agent. What? I'll put the gate agent up. Take this. Take this.
I don't want to take it.
I don't want to take the fine. But yeah, hello.
What part am I playing?
She does play distressed Asian woman well.
No, she's like, oh, God. You know, that sounded a little porny, but...
I liked it.
Yeah. How she does sound really put out and flustered.
Now, that was sincere.
You said these were two phone calls. How far apart were they?
Minutes.
Oh, okay.
That wasn't too far apart.
Okay.
Yeah.
So do you want to hear the post phone call? You want to hear that one, or what do you want to do?
Yeah.
All right, we'll do that. Run a little time. What are you going to do?
Sorry, but yeah.
Okay. She goes, why are you yelling at everyone?
That's what I do.
Sounds like me.
And she said, you hung up. She goes, I go, you did. Because he said he was going to hold you hostage. That pissed me off. I'm irate. He told me not to be angry because he mistakenly said that. I go, nope, he repeatedly said it. He sucks at his job. And that is true.
That's true.
Yeah.
She goes, I'm embarrassed. If not for my bank, I would not pass through all this insult. I go, I am furious. She goes, he just helped me pay and thought my bank issues would be fixed before I leave here. I'm so sorry. I go, then he should take his hostage act to the bank.
Hold on, stop. Did she say he helped her pay?
Yes.
Then what's the issue?
Well, because he wants his money back.
That sounds like their problem, not my problem.
Yeah.
She goes, I'm so sorry. I go, then he should take his hostage act to the bank. I'm sure they will give him all the naira, and that's Nigerian money.
Nice.
She goes, so what do you think I should do now? I go, I can't think straight. I'm seeing red. We will talk later, maybe. If I am ever in the same place as James, my bodyguards will ground him up and turn him into yak food.
I think you pointed out, but they slip big time. You know, if you're going to pay it in naira.
In naira, why isn't
that? Why isn't that in Deutschmarks?
Yep.
Or dollars? Or euros?
Yeah. She's American.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I go, if I'm ever in the same place as James, my bodyguards will ground him up and turn him into yak food. I don't take kindly to his tone and his attitude. She goes, well, I'll be fine. Everyone seems to be hurting me more. I go, I'm not hurting you, but don't bring fools to my door. If someone wants to dance, I'll dance, but it's unwise to make threats to my friends. There is a long list that would second my statement. Since you think I hurt you, I guess this is goodbye. Nice getting to know you, dragon emoji.
Wow.
She goes, why are you really picking on the man that helped me? You don't have much business with him. Though you said you only wanted to hear from him, and now I don't know what you're both turning just little thing to bring much talk. I go, he said he would hold you hostage. I don't take kindly to threats.
When she was going to put him on the phone, wouldn't you think if that was the situation, she would say something? All right, the guy is the gate agent, but he helped me pay, so, you know. To give you a little preamble before jumped on the phone. That's how a normal conversation would go in a situation like that. Am I correct?
Yes, because it's like, you know, this guy is the gate agent and he helped me out. He gave me the money, but the problem is I don't have the money to pay him back before I leave. That's how you set it up.
And then
have the guy talk to you.
You don't just put him on the phone because basically you want it, whatever you want. You want to get the hell out of there. You want to explain what's going on. All right, listen, here's the deal. You want to speak to him? Blah, 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 blah. Right, here's the guy right now. You know, and that's what you would do.
She goes, but I told you, he has apologized to me here and told me he said that out of mistake, and because he was also pissed, he told me you're asking much question, which he never asked nothing when he was helping me. He's a dumbass.
Yeah, he's an idiot.
She continues, would kindly forget about him first, and let's talk about mine. Are you helping me? I go, I need to see you. Proof of life. She goes, so are you trying to say I should still wait till tomorrow? I go, not like you could get a flight now anyway. She goes, what are so bothered about? Seeing it a simple thing, I can call you anytime. She's here, maybe even if she's here soon now. But I just need to pay him the money. I go, it occurs to me that maybe right now I'm talking to James. Been burned before. Hashtag Mugu no more.
Oh, good.
Yeah, nice. Also, another thing on that, she's at the airport, and he paid the fee.
Yeah.
But he won't let her leave until he gets repaid. So what's the fucking point of him paying the fee in the first place?
Right. Yeah, what was the point? Just wait for her and money to come through.
That's a good point.
It's a stupid thing. And I'm sorry, but there has never, ever, once been a gate agent at an airport that would pay your flight for you.
No!
Ever!
No!
Ever!
Tip, you untrusting troll.
Don't say those things.
Well, you know, I'm just saying that because it's airpiece that doesn't fly to Germany.
Oh, well, that's possible. She goes, how do you think I would give my phone to someone else? Are you stupid? Please, it's enough of all this drama. I go, now you insult me? Goodbye, Dragon. She goes, thanks, Dragon Slayer. You're getting me pissed. I go, and you've got me pissed. Asking if I am stupid. How rude. She goes, I hate when you think I'm playing you. I'm not rude, but you're saying much you're not supposed to say. Ain't that the truth?
Yeah, really.
I go, you know I speak my mind. That was one of the things she liked about me.
Yeah.
She goes, I have my pride in this. I'm not just anyhow woman. If not for the little issue you had with my bank, all this would not have been happening to me. I go, I don't know you. I just know you put someone on the phone with me who said he would take you hostage.
Yeah.
She goes, you don't know me. Fine. And don't want to know me, cool. Regardless of everything. Now I gain a chance to understand more about me. Just, what?
What?
Just passing out time with me over everything ever since we met on here. My feelings, my mind, and everything about me. Thanks. Now you can go if you're tired of me. Nice meeting with you on here, though. Think everything happens for a reason in life. I go, you expect unconditional trust? We all have a past.
Yeah, nice. Yeah.
She goes, what do you have as past that concerns helping me with just 500 bucks? That not even worth money. I spend on things that are not much important to me. You not even sending it to me directly. I never told you I need any much thing from which I know I hardly do that.
That's right.
Yeah, sure.
This doesn't worth much talk. I go, huh?
She's so pissed she can't even speak English anymore. Wow. Her ability with language is totally degenerated because she's so flustered.
I go, just show me you were the woman in the picture. Not much to ask for a gift from someone you never met. And who would I send it to? James at Western Union? I am full on calling them on their shit mode.
Oh, yeah. And you know what? They are not even bothering to correct you.
No. She goes, well, once she's here, I will try calling again later. Try to be nice, man. You've been to me, making me happy always. I go, I am nice. But you know how I get when attacked and when people I care about are threatened. You're letting me know you care about me. And then I put a little heart emoji by that, you know, like that.
Oh, look at how fast they're making up.
And I go, if I didn't care, I would let James say he would hold you hostage. She goes, I would not even allow him to do that. They respect me here. And one more thing, maybe. He's just jealous about us.
Oh, wow.
Of course, because you're a couple.
Yes. And you know what?
You're working together on scamming people.
Well, I mean, in real life. But the thing is that on...
the agent's jealous.
Yeah, but if this was for real, like this was like somebody you were interested in, it's just like, yeah, because the agent is jealous about us. It's like, you got a really big opinion of herself. Yeah, that like really. The gate agent is like, you know, oh, he wants me too.
The baggage handler likes me.
I know. It's like, you got to calm down.
She continues, I don't, maybe he intentionally helped because he wanted us to talk. I don't know what the dude is all about. He must be dumb if he's thinking such. I go, why would he be jealous of us? Is there an us? She goes, Ella, don't even know his thinking. That's his concern. I go, didn't you tell him you would send him the money when you got home? She goes, nah, can't even tell him that because he thought I would fix my bank issues, maybe waiting one working day, and already told me can't let me go with it and can't even take my flight back home. I go, why aren't you working this out with the woman watching Janie? She goes, yes, already tried. She can't, and Janie did not safe. She goes, before I left home. I go, so out of all the people you know, you pick a guy you never met in person and just started talking to?
Yeah, and he offered up the money?
She goes, you've started again. I'm not actually picking you, Davin. Do you think I'm just going to sit my ass here and keep waiting for one person? I already tried my best. And one more thing, I barely associate with people.
Because I prefer monkeys. What do you mean you barely associate with people?
I go, barely associate with people? Dragon, do you eat them? Maybe I best keep my bodyguards close by. She goes, LOL, please, I don't want to laugh much. We're being serious here. Or are you not? I go, trying to make you smile, Dragon, but with the little emoji. But seriously, I don't want you to barbecue me. I'm making nicey nice. She puts a bunch of laughing emojis. Nah, it's chicken stew. I go, okay, as long as you don't roast me. She goes, want to be honest, I have never met a man like you. Ain't that the truth? Think you would have left me alone even in this hard time and passing through. You still always make me happy at the end of every each day. Think I would never forget about you. I pray you remain the same person. I go, I am the same person I am. Han, I am unique. She goes, okay, hope so. What are you doing at the moment besides chatting? I'm cleaning up the oil from earlier. Such a mess. She goes, LOL. I know you're just joking. Hun, if I was covering myself at all, taking advantage of myself while thinking of you, I don't think I would tell you. She goes, okay. I go, LOL, is that something you would want me to tell you? And that was it for that day.
Whoa. That was crazy. And the fact that you had this big argument with this guy that she put on the phone, and now she's like trying to turn it around to like a lovey-dovey stuff
again. I think I turned it around too.
Oh, yeah, you did.
I turned on the old fake Davin charm.
Yeah, you did. So, wow.
I don't know why she's bothering with you. If it's this much time to get the money and that didn't work, I don't know what the incentive for her to... What's her incentive to stick with you?
Because it doesn't usually get this far in the scam.
But you know
what? I'm still here entertaining this nonsense.
We've asked this before, though. Why, when he is a federal case to get money out of, why do they stick
around? Yeah, but now the federal case can get pardoned, so you stick around. but we got to remember, they don't get this far.
Yeah.
I'm still hanging in there. To them, I'm still buying some of this bullshit.
Right.
I'm not buying James, but I'm all in on Hanh.
Right.
I'm not questioning Hanh.
Right.
You know, I just don't like him. I was insulted the way he called her a hostage. I did not like that.
No, you should have been insulted.
I was insulted.
Yeah.
So this was probably a bad day for them.
Well, I don't know how they usually perform, but this was just objectively bad. What'd you say?
It was a rough day at the office. Yeah.
Yeah, it was.
So are we happy with the way fake Davin handled that?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Not happy with how they handled themselves.
Well, it definitely sounds like an Asian woman.
Yeah, it does.
It definitely sounds like an African man.
Yeah, and it does. And especially because of the things that he said. And when he was called, like, he was on the spot to pick an airline that he works for. He picks someone that doesn't even go to Germany. What a maroon. That's his. He knows what he knows. So Airpiece jumped into his head and he said it.
So the question is, who's running this scam? Her? Him? I don't even know.
I don't even know.
I don't even know either.
Not clear yet.
So we'll finish that up.
Yeah.
We were happy with the turn of events.
Yes.
Another phone call in the books.
Yeah. Yeah. I was surprised. It would have been better to have video, but the phone call's good.
Yeah.
It gives us more to, you know, work with, try to figure out who the cast of characters and hearing their voices and hearing their accents. Yeah.